guys, today we're learning about the properties of pure substance. Now the basic question arises is, what is a pure substance? Pure substance, it is a single component system. That is, its chemical composition remains constant throughout its mass. For example, water. In this lecture, we'll be learning the PV, TS and PT diagram of water in three different phases. Pure substance can exist in all the phases. For example, solid, liquid, gas, plasma and even gas and condensate. Now, we'll have a brief definition of what is mixture. Mixture is a combination of more than one pure substance. For example, water and ethanol. This is mixture. Now we're learning what is phase. Phase is a thermodynamic region in which the physical properties, for example, melting point, its boiling point remains constant. What is phase change? Phase change is a transition between two different phases. Now I'll be explaining it through different graphs. First, we will start with TS diagram. We'll take T on Y axis and S on the X axis. S is the entropy change. Now let us first consider ice, which is enclosed in a piston, which is maintaining a constant pressure of 1 atm. Ice is enclosed in the piston. Ice is initially at minus 10 degrees Celsius. We'll be supplying heat to the enclosed ice. You can see the point, it's marked as 1. That is ice initially at minus 10 degrees Celsius. Now we'll be heating the ice from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. There is an increase of temperature from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. This point will take as 2. Now at 2, there will be phase change. That is, ice at 0 degrees Celsius will get converted into water at 0 degrees Celsius at constant temperature and pressure. You could see this is 0.3, that is ice at 0 degrees Celsius, which is represented by 0.2, gets converted into ice water at 0 degrees Celsius, that is represented by 0.3. Now we'll again heat. We'll heat the water at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 100 degrees Celsius. So there is increase in temperature. This is 0.4, which is representing water at 100 degrees Celsius. Now at 4, boiling occurs. That is, water at 100 degrees Celsius gets converted into steam at 100 degrees Celsius. This is 0.5. This is steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Now, further we'll increase the temperature to 250 degrees Celsius. Let's assume it. We're increasing. That is, it's superheated condition. The steam is further heated. Now you can see that during the process 2 to 3, there is phase change. That is, ice absorbs the latent heat of fusion and it gets changed into 0 degrees Celsius water. So this is done by absorbing the latent heat of fusion. And then we have phase change from 4 to 5, that is boiling occurs. It occurs when the water at 100 degrees Celsius absorbs the latent heat of vaporization. Now, I would like to mention one more point, that the area within this curve represents the heat supply, that is Q, since Q is equal to T dS. There is entropy change from 1 to 2, which is represented by mCp dT by T. Since entropy change is equal to, since we know Q is equal to T dS, and entropy change is equal to Q by T. For minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius, mCp dT is equal to minus 10 degrees Celsius minus 0 degrees Celsius divided by T. So it is mCp ln T, where we will integrate it from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. Similarly with the process 3 to 4, where we will be integrating it from the 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. For the region 2 to 3 and 4 to 5, entropy change will be given by mL. For this, L is latent heat of fusion divided by T. T is 273 Kelvin, that is 0 degrees Celsius. And here, from 4 to 5, entropy change is given by mLV, that is latent heat of vaporization divided by temperature, that is 100 degrees Celsius, that is 373 Kelvin. Now, as we are more concerned with liquid region, since in most of the power cycle, liquid is only used as the fluid. So we'll be drawing this liquid vapor region in another curve, in another graph. You could see, this graph is drawn on a pressure of 1 atm. Similarly, we'll be drawing it on three different pressures. You could see this is 1 atm, this is 2 atm, and this is 3 atm. Let us assume. This is first, I would like to mention one more point. 2, 3, 4, 5. This is all our saturated states. Saturated state means at constant temperature and pressure, there is phase change. Suppose in state 2, what ice at 0 degree Celsius gets converted to water at 0 degree Celsius at constant pressure and temperature. Pressure is 1 atm and temperature is 0 degree Celsius. Similarly with points 4 and 5. That is, at point 4, water at 100 degree Celsius gets converted into steam at 100 degree Celsius at a constant temperature of 100 degree Celsius and pressure of 1 atm. So 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the saturated states. So basically, I would like to provide one definition that a saturated state is a state in which the change of phase occurs at a constant temperature and pressure. Within the region 1 to 2, the ice exists in solid state. Within the region 3 to 4, ice exists in liquid state, and above 5, it exists in vapor state. 2 to 3 is the transition of liquid and solid. 4 to 5 is the transition of liquid and vapor, and above which it's vapor. Now, let's assume three different curves at different pressures. This is point 2, this is point 3, this is point 4. Since we are more concerned with liquid region, so we are taking 1, 3, 4, 5 and another curve at different pressures. This is all the saturation states, 4 to 5. So we'll be drawing one curve through all the saturated points. See, this is the curve which is drawn to the saturated liquid points. Like 4 is actually the saturated liquid point with respect to vaporization, because at 4, the liquid gets converted into vapor. And 5 is the saturated vapor state. That is when we take the heat of condensation out from the vapor, it is getting condensed into liquid. You could see this is liquid plus vapor region. This is liquid region and this is vapor region. This transition, this is the transition zone. You could see the transition of liquid plus vapor. It gets on decreasing with the increasing temperature or increasing pressure, and it finally becomes zero at this point. This point is known as critical point. At critical point, density of liquid is equal to density of steam. At critical point, now you could see that liquid vapor transition is finally zero. Now I would like to introduce one more concept, that with increase of the pressure, that is when pressure increases from 1 atm to 2 atm to 3 atm, you could see that liquid vapor transition zone decreases. That is, there is a decrease in the enthalpy, that we require very less enthalpy to get the liquid converted to vapor state. And finally it becomes zero at critical point. This concept is used in the pressure cooker. So you can see here that critical pressure for water is 225.65 bar and critical temperature for water is 374.15 degrees Celsius. Now, RL mentioned the study the behavior of water through PV diagram. In PV diagram, the ordinate is taken as P and the seesaw is taken as V. Now, here let us assume ice at minus 10 degrees Celsius. Here also it is enclosed in a piston which is maintaining a constant pressure of 1 atm. Let us consider point 1 as ice at minus 10 degrees Celsius. Now, ice is heated to 0 degrees Celsius. That is, we know that when we increase the temperature, the volume of the solid also increases. 2 is, you can see, one point is minus 10 degrees Celsius ice and point 2 is ice at 0 degrees Celsius. Now at point 2, the ice will melt. That is, at constant temperature and pressure, ice would get converted into liquid. That is, we will obtain point 3. That is,
as you know that it's a peculiarity of water that volume decreases when the ice melts. So 0.3 is 0 degree Celsius water. Now when we heat the ice from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius, its volume increases due to thermal expansion. So the fourth point is 100 degree Celsius water. Now when we heat the ice from 100 degree Celsius, we'll obtain the steam at the 0.5. There is large increase in the volume when we heat the water at 100 degree Celsius to steam at 100 degree Celsius. 0.5 is obtained. From 4 to 5, boiling occurs. That is, water at 100 degree Celsius gets converted into steam at 100 degree Celsius. Now, the steam is further heated to 0.6. That is at 250 degree Celsius. This set of points we have obtained for 1 atm. Now, similar points will be obtained for different pressures. When we increase the pressure, as we know that solid contracts on heating, so the points 1, 0.2, 0.3, they will be shifting towards left. As I would also like to mention that we are concerned with the liquid, since liquid is used in the most of the vapor cycles, so we'll be generally concerned with 0.3, 4, 2, 5 only. We'll not be concerned with the 0.1 and 6. So when we increase the pressure, 0.2, it will shift towards left. These sets of points are at different pressures. 0.3 will also shift towards left. With increase of pressure, ice contracts, that is melting point decreases, and with increase of pressure, boiling point increases. So the fourth point will shift towards right. And the fifth point will be shifting towards left. Now, we have obtained these sets of points at different pressure. Already I have mentioned that 2, 3, 4, 5, these are the saturation states. That at this stage, for example at 2, the ice at 0 degree Celsius will get converted into water at 0 degree Celsius. And similarly at 0.4, water at 100 degree Celsius will get converted into steam at 100 degree Celsius. Now, when we join all the saturation points, for example, when we join all the 2 points, these are the 2 points, this we obtain this as saturated solid line. Actually 2 is saturated solid state, because across 2 only the solid will be getting converted into liquid. Now when we join 3, we'll be getting a curve like this. 3 is actually saturated liquid state with respect to solidification. That across this, solid liquid will be getting converted into solid. Now, we'll be joining 4th point and 5th point. I'm rubbing this all this out. So, we'll be obtaining graph like this. We'll draw a straight line across this. And this is triple point line. Across this, all the three phases, that is solid, liquid and vapor, will exist in equilibrium. Now, this 2 and 3, between 2 and 3, ice and water will exist in equilibrium. So between this, there is solid plus liquid. Between 4 and 5, liquid and vapor will be existing in equilibrium. So there will be liquid plus vapor. And to the right of 5, only vapor will be existing. Now you can see, this is known as sublimation curve, because across towards the left of 3 will be solid will be existing, and here we have vapor. So across this, sublimation will occur. That is, solid will be getting converted into vapor, or vapor into solid. Now I have been drawing this graph clearly.
this is vapor, this is liquid plus vapor, here is solid plus liquid, this is liquid, and here is solid plus vapor.
So this is sublimation line. This is a saturated solid, saturated liquid line with respect to solidification. This is a saturated liquid, this is saturated solid line. This is saturated liquid, this is saturated liquid line.
This one, saturated liquid line
with respect to vaporization, because the liquid will be getting converted into vapor. And this is saturated liquid line with respect to solidification, because the liquid will be getting converted into solid. So this is saturated liquid line with respect to solidification, and here we have saturated vapor line. Now, I would like to plot a typical isotherm for this PV diagram. As I have already mentioned that we are concerned with the liquid state, so I will be removing this all solid states here. And we obtain a graph somewhat like this. Here we have liquid plus vapor, here we have liquid, and here we have vapor. This is saturated liquid line, this is saturated vapor line. And a typical isotherm is like this, this, and this. Now, let us assume a point here, A. When A is compressed, that is when we are increasing pressure of the vapor at A, it will be reaching a point B with the increase of pressure. With isothermically, that is along this line, temperature remains constant. Suppose assume it as T1. Now at point B, at constant temperature and constant pressure of suppose like P1, B, the vapor at B gets converted into liquid. Let us assume it as C. That is phase change occurs. Condensation of vapor occurs. Now you can see that this line is almost vertical, because we require a very large pressure to compress a liquid. So this line is almost vertical. This is a typical isotherm of PV diagram. Now when we increase the pressure, temperature also increases. This is T2. T1 is greater than T2, it's greater than TC. The isotherm which passes through the critical point, that is where liquid plus vapor transition is equal to 0, that is known as critical isotherm. This is a critical isotherm. And the temperature at this point is, and the pressure at this point is known as critical pressure, and volume at this point is known as critical volume. Now I have already mentioned that critical pressure is 225.65 bar and critical temperature 374.15 degree Celsius. Now we will study the behavior of water in all the three phases through PT diagram. We will take P on the y axis and T on the x axis. Already we have taken ice at minus 10 degree Celsius, so we will be taking the same situation. For 1 atm, let us consider the situation. Ice is initially at minus 10 degree Celsius. This is point 1. Now when we heat the ice from minus 10 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius, there is increase of the temperature. So we obtain 0 degree Celsius here. This is point 2, that is 0 degree Celsius ice. Now at 2 we'll have melting of ice. So ice melts to 0 degree Celsius water. So the third point, that is 0 degree Celsius water, will also be obtained on the same point, because the temperature here is 0 degree Celsius. Now further we'll heat the ice water at 0 degree Celsius to obtain water at 100 degree Celsius. So we're getting the fourth point, that is water at 100 degree Celsius. Now at 4, the boiling of water takes place, that is 100 degree Celsius water gets converted into 100 degree Celsius steam. So the fifth point, that is 100 degree Celsius steam, will also be obtained on the same point. This is 100 degree Celsius, this is 0 degree Celsius, and this is minus 10 degree Celsius. Now let us assume that the water is further heated to a temperature of 250 degree Celsius, 2.6. This is 250 degree Celsius. These points are obtained at a pressure of 1 atm. We'll obtain similar points at different pressures. But I would like to mention one more point, that as we increase the pressure, the ice contracts, and so the melting point decreases. But when we increase the pressure, the boiling point increases with the increase of pressure. So the fourth point will shift towards right. Fourth and fifth point will be shifting towards right and with the increase of pressure. And the two and the third point will be shifting towards right, but the increase of the decrease of the melting point is very very less dependent on the increase of the pressure. So there is slight variation of the second and the third point. When we're getting the points somewhat like this at different pressure, these are different pressures. Now when we join all the points, we'll be getting a curve somewhat like this. The line joining points 2, 3, this is fusion curve. The line joining points 4, 5 is vaporization curve. And this is known as sublimation curve. Towards the left of fusion curve, there is existence of solid. Between the fusion curve and vaporization curve, liquid exists, and towards the right of vaporization curve, vapor exists. You could see this is sublimation curve because the solid gets converted to vapor across this line. And this is fusion curve since the solid gets converted to liquid across this line, and across the vaporization line, liquid will be getting converted to vapor. So now you could see that the slope is positive for vaporization curve and sublimation curve for water. But the slope for the fusion curve is negative. So fusion curve slope is negative, the vaporization and sublimation slope is positive. Slope for the fusion curve is negative, and for the vaporization sublimation curve it's positive for water. But for the substances like CO2, we have fusion curve slope is also positive, and vaporization sublimation curve's slope is also positive. Now, two points to be mentioned. As we increase the pressure and temperature, as we have already seen in the PT diagram, as we have already seen through the PV and the TS diagram, that as we increase the temperature and pressure, the liquid vapor transition zone will decrease and will reach a point that is known as critical point. So, let us assume this as a critical point. This point is critical point because with the increase in temperature and pressure, the liquid vapor transition zone decreases. This point is triple point because at this point all the three phases, solid, liquid and vapor, they exist in equilibrium. This is PT diagram. Now we'll learn two very small concepts: subcooling, compressed liquid, that is subcooling, and superheating. Suppose this is T saturation. When we increase the pressure above T saturation, that is, this is T1, this is known as superheating, and this is known as degree of superheat. That is, when the vapor's temperature is increased above the saturation temperature, we reach a point that is known as superheated vapor. When the temperature of the liquid is decreased below the saturation temperature, it is known as compressed liquid or subcooling. And this is the degree of subcooling. Above saturation temperature it's superheating, and below saturation temperature it's subcooling. Now we'll learn a basic concept called quality. Quality of steam. Quality of steam is represented by X. That is, mass of vapor actually present in liquid and vapor mixture. It's mv by mv plus ml. MV represents the mass of vapor, and MV plus ML represents the mass of liquid and mass of vapor. Suppose this is the curve. This is the liquid plus vapor region. And let us assume this as a saturation temperature at particular pressure. this point is saturated liquid at the saturation temperature and pressure, and this point is saturated vapor. Let us take this point as A and this point as B. At A, we have only liquid, that is mass of vapor is equal to 0. So at A, we have 0 by 0 plus ml is equal to 0. So this point, the quality is equal to 0. And at B, we have mass of vapor, but mass of liquid is equal to 0. So x at B is equal to mass of vapor by mass of vapor plus 0 is equal to 1. So at B, we have 1. So across the saturated liquid line, the quality is 0, and across the saturated vapor line, the quality is 1. So across this line, the quality will be increasing from 0 to 1, like 0, 0.25, 0.5, 0.75, and 1. Now, we'll use the funda of conservation of mass. Total mass at any of the pressure is equal to ma plus mb, m at a plus m at b. Volume is equal to volume at a plus volume at b. Now mv, v is the specific volume. A specific volume is defined as volume per unit mass. So m into v, that is total volume, is equal to m VA plus MVB, MAVA plus MAVB. Now, V is equal to MA by M, VA plus MB by MVB. MB by M is actually the quality, so it is equal to XVB, and MA we could write as M minus MB by M VA plus XVB. Now V is equal to 1 minus X, since M by M will get cancelled, we will have 1, and MB by M is equal to X, 1 minus X VA plus XVB. This is the basic formula of the quality. Now we could also say X as dryness fraction. X is also known as quality or the dryness fraction. When we expand it, we will get V is equal to VA minus XVA plus XVB. That is, V is equal to VA plus XVB minus VA. In many of the books, you will find that VA is used as VF and VB is used as VG. So, V, that is specific volume at particular temperature and pressure, is equal to VF plus XVFG. VFG is equal to VG minus VF, or here I have taken as VB minus VB. This is the formula for quality. Similar formula you could use for entropy and enthalpy, like S is equal to SF plus XSFG. For example, entropy at this point is equal to entropy at this point plus the quality at this point into the difference between this and this, that is S at B minus S at A, and H is equal to HF plus XHFG. Thank you.